What's up everybody, my name is Bo, and in this video I'm going to be shooting a comparison between the stock shocker bolt and the new TechT Enertia shocker bolt. The first thing I'm going to do is shoot a couple of shots over the chronograph with our stock setup. I have a 12 millisecond dwell and an operating pressure of about 181, so 180.6 I believe. And that actually is hovering between 180 and 185. So let's see if I have any first shot drop off with 12 millisecond dwell and 185 PSI. So I definitely got first shot drop off. Now I'm gonna go ahead and clear the barrel and let's get a velocity reading for our stock setup and 185 PSI. All right, so our average velocity is 272.4. Now I'm gonna try lowering the dwell down to 11 milliseconds and seeing what type of first shot drop off we get at 11 milliseconds as well as what kind of velocity. So this is a stock bore, so I'm gonna come down 4 chirps. I'm also going to turn it off and then right back on to clear any first shot drop off setting that it might have. So let's see if we get first shot drop off at 11 milliseconds. So not bad. Let's see what type of velocity that we have though. There was a first shot drop off, definitely. So let's see. Our velocity was 237 and it's definitely getting some first shot, kind of sporadic in there. Now let's come down to 10 milliseconds and see what type of first shot drop off we get, and we'll see if the gun even operates at 10 milliseconds. So 4 more chirps and now we're down to 10 milliseconds and let's see if we get any first shot drop off. So we definitely got first shot drop off. You can see that barely rolled out of the barrel again. So these are only going about 20 feet. Let's see what if my chronograph will even pick them up. No, so the chronograph, they're moving too slow for my chronograph to even pick up. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove my barrel. I'm gonna switch over to the TechT Enertia bolt. I'm gonna leave the dwell at 10 milliseconds. And I'm gonna leave the dwell at 10 milliseconds and the operating pressure at 180, which we're at now. I'm gonna slap the TechT Enertia in and see what it does at 10 milliseconds. All right. So I'm not going to go over too much about the actual installation of the new Enertia bolt. If you guys want some more information about that, we actually have a full install video on our YouTube page. I'm just going to very quickly switch over to the new TechT Enertia. Now I've forgotten my pick, like a genius. No worries though. So I'm gonna throw a light layer of grease on the new Enertia. So while I'm sitting here installing this, I'm gonna explain a little bit about the spring system. Basically what the spring does is it helps it overcome that initial friction that is causing our first shot drop off. When shockers sit around for a little while, they just get a little gummed up and no longer really want to fire that first shot as effectively as they can. So that spring just helps it overcome that first shot, or excuse me, that initial friction. So I'm going to install it with both spacers. All right, so you can see now we have a spring-assisted bolt. I'm gonna reinstall it here. All right, so we are still at a dwell of 10 milliseconds. I'm gonna bring you guys in and show you that we're still at the exact same operating pressure. We haven't changed anything. All right, so let's see if we get any first shot drop off now. Remember, this is at 10 milliseconds, same operating pressure, haven't changed anything. At 10 milliseconds with the stock setup, it wouldn't even fire. Let's see what it'll do with the new Enertia bolt. So no first shot drop off. You can tell there's no first shot drop off whatsoever. Now let's see what our velocity is at. All right, so after five shots, we have a velocity of 305.1. So now I'm just gonna bump it back up to 12 milliseconds and shoot it over the chronograph again. I just showed you guys that at 10 milliseconds with the stock setup, it wouldn't even fire. It had horrible first shot drop off and it really wouldn't even get the balls out of the barrel. Whereas now at 10 milliseconds with the inertia, you can tell there's no first shot drop off. It fires that first ball every time, and we've actually raised the velocity quite a bit. So now I'm gonna bump it back up to 12, which is 8 chirps. And let's see what our velocity is at now. All right, so a quick 10 shots and our velocity is at 315.7. So that really about wraps it up, guys. I just wanted to show you guys that we can totally eliminate first shot drop off even at really low dwell settings, even at settings that the stock bolt will not even operate at, can't even get a ball out of the barrel at. We're operating effectively at 305 feet per second and no first shot drop off whatsoever. And then at the dwell of 12 milliseconds, where the stock engine did work well, the stock bolt did work well, but still had some first shot drop off, we've raised the velocity another like 20 FPS or 30 FPS. Actually, that was like 40 FPS from the 270 that we got. So that really about wraps it up. So I just showed you guys that we're able to totally eliminate first shot drop off. We were able to lower our dwell to a setting that the stock bolt wouldn't even run at. At 10 milliseconds, the stock bolt wouldn't even get a ball out of the barrel. And we were able to slap the TechT inertia in without changing the pressure, dwell, or anything, and get no first shot drop off and be firing at about 315 feet per second. But that doesn't really prove anything as far as an efficiency gain goes. With a sealed dump chamber, the way that the shocker is, you really have to lower the pressure at any given dwell to show an increase in efficiency. So I've raised our dwell back up to 12 milliseconds, and I've lowered our PSI to about 160, 159.0, which if you guys remember is 20 pounds lighter than what the stock bolt was running at. Now I'm gonna shoot a couple shots and show you that we aren't getting any first shot drop off, and then I'm gonna show you what our velocity is at now, 20 PSI later. So I'm gonna pull it back a little bit so you can see that there's no first shot drop off. You can see the ball come out of the barrel. So you know there's no first shot drop off. Now let's see what our velocity looks like. All right, so after just a couple shots, we have an average velocity of 280.9. So that's really what I wanted to do to show you guys that we are improving efficiency. At the same dwell setting, we're operating at 20 PSI lower, and we're still about 10 feet per second higher. So that really about does it. If you guys have any more questions about the inertia bolt or any of our other products, you can visit us at www.techtpaintball.com. That's T-E-C-H-T paintball.com. Or you can visit our YouTube, which is www.youtube.com/TechTPaintball. Again, T-E-C-H-T paintball, no space. Or you can befriend us on Facebook as TechT Paintball. Again, my name is Bo. Thanks for watching, everybody.